What's happening, everybody? I want to welcome you back to the Becker Review for the CPA exam. Again, I'm Peter Olinto, and I'm going to be walking you through BEC3. Now go to the top of page 7. This is what we're most comfortable with. Quantitative relevant costs. I want you all to notice in the second line of number 2, many times quantitative considerations involve in that second line numerical measurements. Now, we're most comfortable with letter A, financial, where that numerical measurement is considered to be a currency. And in our case, it'll be the dollar, let's say. So if we have various alternatives, if I produce the item in-house, it'll cost me $18 a unit. Whereas if I outsource it, we might be able to produce it at $16 a unit. But maybe we won't get the same quality if we outsource it. So nonetheless, quantitative talks again about in the second line, reducing it to a numerical measurement. And letter A, when they talk about financial, we can measure it numerically, but in currency, in our case, the dollar. Letter B, sometimes quantitative information, though, can be measured numerically, but not in a currency. And letter B, do y'all see where it says non-financial? To the right of that. Maybe we're going to measure it in terms of time, slash, it could be units produced. So again, if we could produce it more efficiently, maybe we could save time. That's a relevant cost. Time-wise, measured numerically, producing it in 5 hours versus 8 hours. And then the number of units produced. Can we produce 12 units or 15 units? Again, quantitative in nature, numerical measurement, but not measured in dollars. What I need you all to do next is, Roman numeral 4. When we have various alternatives that we're going to explore, different alternatives, we've got to try to predict what our costs will be, what our revenues will be, what our profit will be in the future. The problem is anytime you're forecasting, it's a probability analysis. We don't know for sure what will happen in the future. So what we're going to discuss in Roman numeral 4 is probability analysis, trying to come up with an expected value. In the first two lines, what is probability? Please highlight. It's the chance that an event will occur. Notice what it goes on to say. Probabilities are assigned values between 0, it's not going to happen, or 10%, or 20%, or 30%, 0 all the way up to 1, 100%. So probability is nothing more than a value between 0 and 1. Letter A, simple terminology, types of probability. Do y'all see A1, objective probability? Please highlight in the first line, objective probability is based on, highlight, past outcomes. Right above that, let me give you an example, i.e. returns on the stock market. Folks, if you take a look at past history, go back 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, we could come up with the average return on the S&P over that period of time. That's an objective probability. Number 2, sometimes probability analysis is not objective, it's subjective. Highlighted number 2, subjective probability, and in the first line, it's simply based on an individual's belief. It's an opinion. Oftentimes, right above that, where do we see that? Put down above that, outcome of a lawsuit. You know from financial accounting, rule of conservatism, if an entity is sued and the probability of loss is more than 50%, let's say we've been sued, we've been named as a defendant, and the loss is probable, and it could be measured, and we could reasonably estimate the amount of the loss, we learned in financial accounting, well, we have to book that immediately. For our purposes here, though, that type of analysis where a lawyer gives you his or her opinion about the probability, the outcome and event, well, that's subjective. That's merely somebody's opinion. It's not based on past outcomes.